Hey y'all, I wanted to shoot a quick video of the importance of keeping your stuff clean. So what I'm gonna go through right now is something more for the beginners, is how important it is to keep your draft system clean. I'm gonna show you my system and some quick and easy ways to set up a system for your draft that makes cleaning really, really easy. First, I'm gonna go through cleaning my beer lines and the system I set up here. Got myself a real simple submergible pump, put a little bit of a line on it, and set up a rig so that I could connect the beer side tap of the keg tops. Two Tupperware bins or anything else that'll hold liquid. Get yourself some really hot water. I use this BLC for my beer lines. This is the first part of the cleaning process, flushing out your lines. My placard is off because this does splash and makes a mess. These two are the two taps that have been empty for a while, and those are the ones I'm getting ready to tap right now. Typically, I do this right when I pull the keg, connect the beer line. Make sure your pump is submerged. Make sure that this tap is full bore. I've numbered my line so I know which goes where. The first thing that flushes out of this is gonna be the beer that's still in the lines. It can take a little bit to get these things going because there's air in the line. But luckily, since this is just beer, much better than doing that with gasoline. And what I do is on the first one, once it starts running a little bit cleaner, that's when I'll move it over. And that's it. It's flushing through the line. It's running through through my draft lines, through my tap. And I just let this run like this with the hot water cleaning solution for 15 minutes or so. So this thing's been running for 15 minutes. We're gonna do the same thing on tap number two. Now what I wanna do is you fill this guy up with nice, hot, clean water, and we're gonna flush the system. So I'm gonna move the pump into the clean water. Now we are just running clean water to rinse out all the cleaning solution out of these lines. I will run as many of these through until this no longer has any soapy feel to it. Once this doesn't have any soapy feel to it, I usually let it run for a little bit with just water, like the loop, you know, going back into here and just letting it run with water. And then I'll do one more just to make sure I'm cleaning out all of the line cleaner. I'm not going to do it today because right after I get all this stuff cleaned, I will actually be tapping the kegs that are in there getting pressurized right now. But if I am doing this after a keg, so if I pull a keg out of here and then I clean these lines, which is typically what I do, I just got behind on it because of the coming off the holidays and sick kids. But if I pull the keg out of here and clean the lines and I don't have a keg to put back in, I will run star sand solution into these lines just so that these are sitting with star sand solution instead of just water. I don't know how much of a difference it'll really make because these lines are inside the teaser, so they're refrigerated, so you're not really, it's no different than having, you know, bottled water inside of a fridge. But star sand solution is incredibly easy to make and very, very simple. With all the pumps and everything already hooked up, it's just another second of pouring some star sand in here to run star sand into the lines, just to make sure everything's sitting with a sanitization solution in it while it's not being used. I haven't replaced my draft lines and my system's not really, really old, but I've been told that if you just take care of your draft lines and you keep everything clean, you really never have to replace your lines. And now I just let it run in a closed loop for a little while. I do these taps one at a time. Now I know all these parts, you know, quality control, they should be sized up and everything exactly the same, but I don't like to risk the possibility of putting different parts in these and causing issues down the road. The only thing you're really gonna need from this, for this tool-wise, is one of these. Crack this just to make sure there's no pressure in there. And then remember that these guys are reverse. If you haven't put it on in a while, you might not remember. So it's these guys, you actually rotate them to the right to loosen them. And then this whole collar comes out. And that's it. In there, we're gonna come back once we make our cleaning solution and scrub that little ball out and scrub all around there as well. Come with me to the sink. Back to good old PBR. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this whole thing apart for you guys, and we're just going to soak all the pieces. You start unscrewing stuff. There's there's parts of this that don't really get that dirty, but put them in there anyway. I just took off the collar. That's got a rubber gasket in there. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. This piece comes off. There's a little bit of gurn involved in that, but it does come out. In the back of these things, you'll see they rotate. The thing that keeps them from rotating is this peg in the side. This handle unscrews. And you're looking at this trying to figure out, how the heck do I get that piece off? That's it. I got some of the cleaning solution on my hand, so now everything's slippery. And I'll show you, once you take this out, this is more important for reassembly. But how these things work is, you see that peg is offset. So when you rotate this, if you can see down in there, it goes into that hole that's in there. And then when you rotate it, it moves this piece back and forth to adjust the flow. I lied to you guys, you will need one more tool. Jam a screwdriver in there to push this piece back. Once you push it back past the hole, you'll see the front of it, and you can use that to get it the rest of the way out. There you go. Small scrub brush, something like this, and then any sort of other regular scrub brush, and just clean all your parts. I'm gonna let these soak for a while, because it's good to let this cleaner stuff soak to just break down any beer scale or crud or crap or anything that's been gooped in there for a while. Rinse everything really, really well. Put it back together in exact reverse order. Hey, while that's soaking, I'm gonna show you guys something here. This is a pro tip. This piece of strut up here, when these taps are assembled, when they're on, you can take this top piece off and you can unscrew this. Sorry, I'm right-handed, so I'm blocking y'all. And then wiggle, wiggle, wiggle until the middle piece comes loose, this little piece right here. And then you can rotate this 180. The reason why I showed you that is, if you have your tap handle on, and you've labeled one side of it, and then you put it in, and the side that you want facing out is backwards, take that piece off, take the thread out, rotate it 180, put it back together, screw your tap back on. It's easier to do it that way when this is all put together, because everything is just slightly off, especially with my build, because this is all handmade. Everything that's put in here, these pieces of wood, I made all these tap handles, as you could tell, because they're not all exactly the same. This is all handmade stuff, so things are slightly off. So just like when you're working with an engine or something like that, once things are worn in and they're working, it pays to keep things in their same groups. With the faucets, it might not make a difference because these are machined, these are made at a factory, and there's quality control on the measurements, but it's just easier to keep everything grouped together the way it should be, keep the same tap handles on the same faucets, keep everything the same when you're doing your cleaning. That way you don't deal with anything like, oh, this one's a little bit off, or this one's slightly slanted, or everything's adjusted the way it was when you took it apart. If you have a batch in your keg and you start getting, and you were getting good pours, and you start getting bad pours, really foamy pours, and when you're not at the bottom of the keg where it's about to empty, it's probably time to clean your tap. The beer lines can last a lot longer. The tap itself starts to get build up. Make sure that when you put it in, this nub where it's going to line up is actually in the right position so that you can get it with the tip of this. Because that piece needs to go in there so that, and it didn't get, I didn't get it. And you'll see it'll seat properly when it's in, and then when you rotate it, it'll move this piece like it's supposed to. And that's how you know you got it in the right spot. Once you've got it in, you can unscrew this, get the piece back on, get the correct piece back on, and then put your handle back in. When I got these, I had to use pliers to get these little handles out. The first time, I don't know, just the way they're shipped, mine were so tight that I could not get them out just with the grip of my ham. I had to use pliers the first time. This one goes in. Not sure if I'm putting it in the right direction. I'll find out once I get it on the tap. That's it. Give everything a quick check for functionality. Don't over tighten these things. Tighten them down enough where everything seals, but you don't have to gir these things down to make them beer tight. Get it, beer tight. Another thing I'm going to show you, when you install this, when you put it in, you want to rotate it so that that piece is all the way forward. Makes it easier to put this thing together. Clean these out as well. I also clean this thread, basically the outside groove. It doesn't really get dirty because beer doesn't really come in contact with it. Mainly the in here where the beer flows through and where the flow is restricted because of the bulb in the back. That's where you'll get your gunk. That's also the most critical spot, or one of the most critical spots, where when the gunk does build up, it'll start to give you foamy pours, even though your beer is fine. To remind you again, these are threaded, reverse threaded. Well, not really reverse threaded if you're standing from the back, but from the front, they'll be considered reverse threaded. Get everything lined up before it's seated as you tighten down, because once those notches line in there, your tap shouldn't rotate anymore. If it does, it's because it's rotating the entire shank. Again, check for functionality. And what I do now is I check to see that my orientation of the shaft is correct. Yep, and that is the piece that I want facing forward. So we're good.